Hello and welcome to Pioneers Talk. My name is Tom Witter, and today I have Bernd Linzer with me. Hi, Bernd.
Good morning, Tom. Thank you for inviting me to this discussion.
You're welcome. So why is Bernd with us today? Bernd is the Vice President of Endless Strip Production at Primetals Technologies, and he oversees both the technology and sales aspects of Arvedi ESP. And Bernd, when we spoke about today's session, you mentioned something that I found rather interesting. I asked you what you really liked about your job, and you said it was finding the ideal plant configuration for every single customer, and that it was very different from customer to customer. Can you elaborate on that? How do you do that? How do you find the ideal plant configuration?
Absolutely right. You can imagine when you have different customers in different areas, so the markets are totally different. And at the end of the day, the customer wants to place his product on a certain market where it can range from very different products, from thin strip to heavy gauges. Mm-hmm. And for every customer, the challenge is for myself then to find the optimum configuration and features into a certain implementation to allow him to produce the best product on the lowest cost basis for sure for this market, which is then ranging from very different products, from low carbon light gauges to maybe pipe steel grades on very heavy gauges up to 1 inch.
Uh-huh. Oh wow, I mean that's an extremely wide portfolio in terms of products. Is it possible to make all those with Arvedi ESP? Because, you know, you're the Arvedi ESP guru, at least in my world, right? So is it possible to do all these grades?
Thank you for that compliment, first of all.
Yeah, sure.
No, but it's absolutely. We have different features we can implement into an ESP line to allow all these steel grades and these different steel products on these lines. And what we always try is to give the possibility to our customers to utilize the advantages of the endless production for all these steel grades. Mm-hmm. And this is then for sure also linked to, as I mentioned before already, the production costs and the quality of the strip. With the endless process, you always have the advantage that you can reduce from the very first meter of a strip until the very last meter of a strip with the same high quality aspect, parameters as you can not do with a batch production.
So it's very, very consistent quality?
Consistent quality, and you even have the opportunity not to only produce the same strips like you have on a conventional mill, but you can even improve this by, for example, optimizing the alloying strategy for certain products and to save further money on alloying elements on that point.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so it's a very efficient technology on many levels, right? And I think one other argument that you like to put forward is that the strip made with Arvedi ESP is direct application products. So does that mean that there's no additional processing required or hardly any additional processing required?
Absolutely right. What is the big advantage of the endless production as well is that you can target a very thin product, which is ranging from 0.6 millimeter, which was done on a Chinese implementation last year. Mm-hmm. On hot rolled strip. This is definitely the world record in thinnest hot rolled strip ever made.
Okay.
For that. But ranging up for sure also with different steel grades in the very thin gauges like 1.5 millimeter for high strength material as well. You can use this material to streamline the cold rolling process and to utilize this material to go directly to the market. Mm-hmm. So the advantage of the endless production is that you can range into the cold rolled thicknesses which are well known on the market, but also within the product quality available with the cold rolling. And with the ESP process, then you only have to add downstreams a pickling or pickling and galvanizing line to come up with the end product you can place directly to the market, instead of going through all the process chain of a full integrated mill.
Mm-hmm. Actually, that's interesting, because that means that if you combine an ESP line with an electric arc furnace, is that possible, by the way? Because if that is possible, then you can radically make the whole plant radically more compact and probably much more efficient.
Absolutely, absolutely. And there is already certain implementations available and in operation on the market. For example, if you look to the carbon footprint of a full integrated mill coming from blast furnace, POF, secondary metallurgy, and then hot rolling facilities, cold rolling facilities, and then the downstream facilities to come up with the product, you can replace with a very compact implementation of an electric arc furnace, secondary metallurgy, and an ESP line, which is able to produce the right products already in the thickness and mechanical properties capable to the market. Then you only have to add a pickling or pickling and galvanizing line to come up with the same product as you have on the market with the full integrated mill.
Mm-hmm. I mean, that sounds very intriguing. Actually, if I were a steel producer today, and maybe there's someone out there listening, okay, and I'm thinking, I have this nice greenfield site there, and that's exactly what I want to do, okay? I want to have an electric steel making plant that uses Arvedi ESP, maybe some pickling. What kind of implementation time would I be looking at? What kind of ramp-up time would I be looking at? Does it take very long time, very short time?
We can demonstrate that we have done this recently in very short times.
Okay.
Even the implementation, which is changing a bit with the market situation right now, that we cannot achieve very shortest times, which were down to 18 months. But I would say nowadays the typical implementation time would be globally average, maybe something like 24 months. But very important is what you addressed as well, is the ramp-up time, because this is where the customer starts to earn money. Mm-hmm. And there we can really be proud on some records we have done recently, where we have shortened the time as far as possible. And we can definitely guarantee that you can ramp up the mill to full production, and also all the quality aspects for high value added products within 6 months.
6 months.
To arrive at the final acceptance and the final tests within 6 months.
Wow. I mean, that sounds very confident. How many ESP lines have you implemented? It sounds like you have gained some experience. So when was the first line implemented? How many have you done?
So right now, we have 10 implementation.
Okay.
Where the 10th will be start up.
Okay.
Yeah, end of the year.
Okay.
And the 11th will follow next year. So we have very big experience in starting up these lines for sure, but also with the different customers, with different types of mills we have installed there. So there is really the portfolio coming from thinnest gauges, lowest carbon contents within the steel grades, up to advanced high strength steel grades, up to the line pipe steel grades, and everything available.
I think some of the countries you've sold ESP lines to has been Italy, basically, China, and the US, is that correct?
Correct, yes.
And with the trend toward electric steel making, do you expect that demand will grow even further?
We have discussions all around the world, you can say, where definitely the carbon and the green steel topic is becoming very famous and is driving to optimize this carbon dioxide emission as far as possible. And there were projects, ideas arriving all around the world to optimize the steel production for flat steel.
So ESP is already quite green, okay? Can it become even greener than it is today in the future? That's my last question, by the way.
Definitely. By definition, there's always a possibility to optimize. Yeah. So, but we have done it already to quite an extent, as you said. And if you compare a typical implementation of a full integrated mill towards an compact mill, like an ESP line and an electric arc furnace up front, you can say that you can lower the carbon footprint of such a mill of more than 2,000 kilogram or 2 tons carbon dioxide per ton of steel down to a few hundreds. So this is a really dramatic reduce, and within the process itself, within the ESP process and downstreams, even you can say that we can fully avoid carbon dioxide emissions, and this is the only technology available where you can fully avoid these emissions.
As we can see, Bernd Linzer is pointing the way to the future, I want to thank you for taking the time today to speak with us. We'll be back with yet another episode of Pioneers Talk. Until then, goodbye. Thanks for watching.